Hey everybody, thought I'd try something a little different today. So today this video is going to be this. This is a comic book cover for Spawn done by Todd Mcfarlane. I think it was 92. I came across this in my searching and I just love the contrast and the color. And yeah, so this is the video. The first part of the video is going to be real time with me talking about what I'm doing. So if that's not your style, I will put a timestamp in for the time lapse, which will be the majority of the painting will be time lapse. Just the first part will be real time. So here we go. All right, got my palette all set up. Gotta have coffee. So let's start. So you're going to be doing the background, which is a sky scene here. Let's just get this paper a little wet first. Don't want to get it too wet here. Want some control, but do not want to be starting off with dry paper in this situation here. I'm going to try to go for good smooth transitions and color. Alright, there's that. Yellow in here. I think this is a medium yellow. I'm just gonna slowly transition to darker. And we're gonna go into some gold ochre here just a little bit. The main force will be this crimson red coming next, and that's where we're going to get our real orange. Looks like we need some more water. Using our lighter transitions here, so let's come back in here and throw some more yellow in. Now, let's go into some ultramarine right now. Get that pretty dark. Maybe add just a little bit of neutral tint. And let's just do that right now. Some on the horizon here. All right, now to purple. Thank you. need some more red in here. Working from the horizon now again. Some ultramarine. A little bit of neutral tint. Just a little bit. That's a bit too much. I'm gonna come back here, soften that just a little bit. We lost our wet edge right there. So we're gonna grab a little bit of gold ochre, just soften that edge a little bit there. And we're gonna have to go to the spray bottle. Get some mud going on here. So what we're gonna do, start working our way up. Down a little bit. Want some of that. In here with some more just straight yellow, not even any water. Try to fight that purple coming in a little bit. A little bit more gold ochre. Again, to try to fight off that purple that's creeping in. Transition. We need some more red. They're building up some clouds here in the background a little bit. And just a little red line there. Connect some clouds. Clean up this a little bit. So we want that as bright as possible. That's probably going to stay pretty much white in the center of this cross here. Maybe soften those edges up a little bit. Some more yellow. See, we're starting to get a little bit of mud there, so grab some more yellow and push that down off to the side. Pick some up of this mud color here, and then throw in some yellow. Soften those edges up a little bit. All this got dry on me, so we're just gonna push all that there. Into that. Soften this horizon just a little bit. Throw a couple shapes in there too. Maybe a city in the
in the far distance. Throw some color in here too. Alright, so now we definitely lost some orange here, so I'm going to throw some crimson back in here. Just soften these edges up and create a good transition. Alright, I think that's good to place a stop right now. We'll let that dry and we'll move on. Alright, so the background's dry, ready to go to the next step here. Normally I'd probably just work my way all the way down with the first wash, but trying something a little different here, so we're going to focus more on the background here and possibly just finish it and then work our way down. So the first thing we're going to do here is come in on this cross here. With some bright orange. And what this is going to do is portray the light bending around this cross here. And we're going to come in here with some purple too on the edges. To get a transition. I'm just going to brown up a little bit, but that's all right. And then push everything from the center out, so we're not dragging that purple inward. Looks like we need some more red in there around the edges. Soften those up. Maybe darken up the center here where these two posts on the cross meet up. All right. I'm using a smaller brush here just to get the outline, so it's gonna pop so much against the sky. Just kind of want to make sure that this part isn't too off angle or crooked. it's not dark enough. We'll come back once it's dry and do another layer. I think it's looking good so far. Do a few touch-ups. But so far so good. Yeah, once this dries, definitely gonna have to get some yellow in there to help with this transition. But I think for the most part, it's looking good. Try to round out this a little bit. Some more dark value into those cross beams. All right. Now that that's out of the way, let's do these two other crosses here. And we are going for a bigger brush now. A little less detailed. This is definitely not going to be dark enough, so we'll come back with a second wash if we need to. And it looks like I lost my sketch line here in the paint, so I'm just kind of guessing here, seeing how this is going to look. Yeah, sometimes that just happens. Overpaint your guidelines. That's all right. And we're not going to go any further down on that because we got a little bit of the horizon, the land back there to do. So we'll just leave that for now. Touch ups here. Out, so we're gonna have to widen this whole thing, but you know, like I said, no big deal. All right, finish up this. All right, on to the third final. This one really got lost in the color, but we can find it. Right here. This one does have a hole in the center where some light is shining through, so gotta keep that in mind. I recently just got this quill brush. I've never used one before, and let me tell you, it is the way to go. Carries a ton of paint, but you can get in here with some details with that nice point. It is definitely the way to do it. At least for these initial washes. Come back in here with a smaller brush, fine-tune some things, but this is definitely the way to go. All right. Fine-tune the background just a little bit, those crosses. Add some more yellow here. But what we're going to do right now, speed things up a little bit, add some music. Here we go. Thank you.
Thank you.